Like Bobelter's trying to do the same thing, but Meteos not playing already the odd one style. He's playing the attack style. Level 3 coming in. The black shield goes down very early there. Mop may be able to get that off here. The flash and the flame comes in, and it's going to be just enough. The boomerang coming back. A few more hate spikes. The red buff could have done it, but Eleven Nation wants to take that one for himself. In the lane, this is going to be quite bad for him. He does have the shield, but he doesn't know that Meteos is there as well. That's when he goes, oh, yeah, there's three. Sneaky able to pick that one up for himself.
Bit the Pantheon ult to come in, but they don't know that ThinkCard is on the other side of the map. They're just going to go anyway.
Oh, I don't know if Balls wanted to dice out of that as fast as he did. They're still able to get in for the rest of the damage, but he's forced to flash to get back in here.
Big force today.
There we go. He sees it. I don't know if he's going to want to see it, though. Puts himself close. Gets a good slow down there. Pantheon drop coming in. And that's going to be a double drop. A Pobelt is going to be dead. ThinkCard may not have wanted this just yet, and he is going to get locked up for the duration of that hook. Now the play, double kill coming in for high, and that one was delivered to him. Now Meteos provides chase onto Ken. He is not going to get help from Robert actually in the bottom lane. They are disjointed as well, and Robert's going to be alone now. Game 80-80 in the CS, one death to the assist, but that was only in the 2v1 tilt of the jungle. Now it's the 2v1 tilt with the mid lane in favor of EG. Balls is going to slice into the fight. Maybe dice out, was just using the last one actually, and he goes down to Pobelter on a good roam.
For an eventual Bloodthirster, it's not wasted, but it's just a huge amount of early power.
Oh, so close, two more of those shots of the Culling would have been it. Oh, he gets the Q on the max range! Sneaky coming up very big there. Lane, it's that time of the Rift again. Hook coming out, Robert X. Lee is gonna get himself a black shield here, but I don't know if it's gonna be enough. They click it off immediately, but he shields out the Flay and then gets hooked. Here comes the Pantheon drop. ThinkCard coming in. He's still quite under level, or not under level, but under itemed on this. But it's enough for the team to pick up a kill, and it's what they needed.
Hey, the shutdown, and then the fight in the top lane. Ball's going to Inox.
That is going to be Inox taking quite a bit of damage. You can see just by the health bars how squishy Inox is with his build of damage. High now in the mid lane. The death mark is off, but he flashes, getting in that last E attack. Good for him. Woo. Inox is going to be going down. Call of the Meek to bring in the kill.
While the ganks continue to flow bottom, and they got a ward on this blue buff. ThinkCard might have to fall back.
That's going to be one more attack. The shurikens will be enough to take him out.
One more spell.
Oh, he denied the assist. That was actually pretty nice.
Experienced, powerful Cloud9 team. Here comes a Pantheon gank, though, trying to make something happen.
That's the drop. They actually get the stun down onto Lemon, which leaves Sneaky able to do free damage that entire time. ThinkCard gets out. Sneaky almost grabs himself double buffs. They know they can work it at any point in time, especially with high on Zed getting this blip push down. He calls over Pobelter. This looks like it could be a good one for one here. I don't think High is going to have... Oh, he doesn't have time to go back in on the death mark. Doesn't have any turret gold in their favor. It's all been what they've been able to fend for themselves. A very back and forth. Pobelter trying to dodge. He dips, and it's going to be one less shot. He is invulnerable, and he is safe. Oh, no! He tries to get the piercing light.
Oh, no.
Oh, Meteos.
Aww.
Aww. Right now, they pretty much own both sides of the map. Those turrets are about to be signed over to Cloud9. Right now, Balls is doing what he can to have a say about this fight, and he just took on four members of EG, only having to pop Dominus.
He just keeps dying here. Look how Pobelter, he's got his ult.
Whoa!
Very well, if they do decide to turret dive, Balls can go in and take the turret for themselves. A little bit of a duel down bottom here. Great ult by Pobelter, though.
Trying to deny vision of the brush.
Whoa!
There's a little bit of lifesteal for you as well.
High's a little bit low as well. Oh, no.
No, that
was
a vision that they didn't see. Pobelter is going to be the one that's locked up on this. Not too much crowd control for him. He's going to be able to get a heal off for a bit of a speed steroid, but it's not going to keep him alive. Cloud9 in full control of the map and now the bottom lane. Oh, on the outside.
They want revenge. They want to kill High.
Waiting pretty long on the intervention here. Throws it on as soon as he knows the rest of the damage is going to be happening. It looks like he's going to be able to walk this one out. Almost gets in range. He's got enough lifesteal to do this. And he does take down Pobelter with him.
See if he can get it. He might,
actually. ThinkCard dives in. Oh, it's just too late, unfortunately. A great try by him. Balls has the dice to get over the wall. Ken's going to get a dark binding onto him. Inox has the black shield, but it's for AP, not the AD.
That doesn't stop culling bullets, unfortunately. He got culled, that's for sure.
He can be the tank that they need. And the minion waves are actually here to offer a little bit of assistance.
Hook.
The grab onto Pobelter. He gets the intervention down with the black shield, and they're going to be able to get out. The soul shackles only doing so much as they sackle the shoal of Ken himself. 20-4 in this one, looking for the shutout on turrets. And it looks like Cloud9 can stay in the base a little bit longer. And maybe they have extended their stay on this one. Dishing out the damage. Lemonation on the backside gives a little bit of crowd control over to Meteos. It's what he needed for a triple. Balls on the backside was taking down turret. Oh, he says, all right, hook. Now I'm here for the fight. The point blank hooks over and over for the ace. Cloud9, 28 minutes into the game, are going to pull out the victory. 24 kills to 6.
Yeah, they forced that one in at the end, but it was all worth it. They knew they had a huge lead, and even if they lost, they would still be able to win that game. So 28 minutes, 24 kills, domination by Cloud9. We'll be right back.